We know very little about the causes of cancer of the pancreas. And I strongly advocate, I mean, I didn't do any of the studies myself, but or lab, but I mean, about 20 years ago, I put in a grant application to study cancer of the pancreas and hepatitis B virus, and that which wasn't successful. But I'd love to see more work done on it. You know, you have human T cell leukemia virus 1 and 2, which is fairly common in parts of Japan. It's common in equatorial Africa. And there's nasopharyngeal carcinoma, which is quite common in southern Asia. There's a tumor associated with there's several bacterial ones. The cancer of the stomach, you know, may have a connection with pylori bacteria, Helicobacter pylori. And I'm sure there are many others. And sometimes the connection may not be clear. As I mentioned before, everything has multiple causes. So in some cases, the virus may have some role, but not, there may be other causes, so to speak. But actually, one of the things you want in medical research in particular is you want complicated answers. You want complex answers, not simple ones. Because the more the more you know about different mechanisms, the more places you can intervene. And that's what's happening in drug therapy. Now we know more and more about the molecular biology, and every time some sort of mechanism looks as if you can, find some small molecule that will interfere with it, that's your candidate. That goes into the pipeline. You have some idea of mechanism. You have a cheap drug you can make, synthesize, and that's your next pipeline item. So what we don't want is simplicity. We want complexity, understand as much as you can in order to intervene.